Assalamu alaikum, everybody. This is the first time I've vlogged all day. It's 5 o'clock, 5:01 now. I've gotten like maybe 2.5 hours of sleep, two and a half hours of sleep. I'm so overly exhausted, overly wiped. I'm so glad I took the day off today. I'm so glad I requested the day off because, for one, I knew I was going to be up late. But I didn't know that I was actually going to attend the entire program up until 6 this morning. And even then, we stayed after Fajr. I don't know if we stayed there until 6. But, no, I don't think we stayed till 6, but we stayed until after Fajr, helped clean up, helped put, you know, the food in the warehouses and stuff, and then we came home. I took a shower, washed my face, put on fresh pajamas. No, they're not fresh, but I put my pajamas on because they're clean anyways. And then took my medicine and went to bed. And I woke up like maybe 8 something, 9 something. I don't know what time I woke up, but I woke up and I was so tired and I wanted to go back to sleep. But then I got distracted with things and I was thinking about the computer. I was thinking about, oh my gosh, what am I gonna do? My memory card is going to fill up on this camera. There's gonna be so many clips I have to sort through. I made a decision to get another computer used off of Amazon. It's Asr time, can't pray. I made a decision to get another computer, used computer, like new used computer, which inshallah should come Saturday. I'm going to have so much editing to do. Today's vlog is just going to be very short. The only thing I'm focusing on today is getting my rest. I don't want to get any more lesions. I have some that are actually inflamed for some reason, but through the course of the day, it has the inflammation has gone down on one of them quite drastically, because it was like seriously inflamed. It was on my left leg, and I have another one on my left leg that's kind of inflamed, but it's not as bad as the one that was on the leg. This one was on my thigh, it's not as bad, but the one on my leg was really inflamed. So yeah, my main focus today is try and rest as much as possible so I can go to work tomorrow. And I've got one package that came in from East Essence. I'll show you guys that later when I get the other package that I'm expecting. They're my gloves that I plan on wearing, well, mainly for driving though, but I just want to show you all of that at once and not break it down. So I'll show you inshallah later. The gloves should be coming like later today inshallah. They're out for delivery from what I saw. And I also bought those off of Amazon. But yeah, I haven't done anything. I ate a little bit, I drank a little bit. I should drink more. I'm quite dehydrated, subhanallah. And knowing that I can't fast, I should be hydrating myself. So I'm gonna finish off this little bit of water and fill it up. I don't like drinking lukewarm water, and I think that's why I don't drink as much. So when I'm done with that, I'm going to go and get another full bottle, you know, fill it up with more water and hydrate myself, because I am quite dehydrated. And yeah. But alhamdulillah, subhanallah, I just enjoy just being there. I don't even know how I'm going to edit that vlog. It's just like I don't want to cut anything out because everything is so beneficial. I even did I did it live on Instagram, and so that, you know, some of you can see. I know a lot of you aren't following me on Instagram, so if you're not following me on Instagram, follow me on Instagram. There are times when something is happening and I just want to capture it so that everyone would receive the benefit from it, including myself. So follow me on Instagram at Leilani Niqabi, and that way, when I do go live, you will get a notification that, hey, I'm live, come watch. There's a sister from London that I saw on there yesterday. Assalamu alaikum, sister. Thank you so much for joining. There's another sister there who joined in. And so I would love to see more sisters join in when I go live, inshallah. So make sure you're following me. But yeah, I just wanted to come on here and just give a quick update. I haven't vlogged all day. This is the first time I vlogged, so it's gonna be a super short vlog, which is fine. I need to read, but I'm scared if I start reading, I might start falling asleep. But we'll see how that goes, inshallah ta'ala. But anyways, I love you all for the sake of Allah. I hope you all enjoyed your Laylatul Qadr. If your masjid did a program for you yesterday, what was yesterday? Wednesday the 21st. I don't know what day I'm in. Oh, alhamdulillah. I just enjoyed myself so much just being amongst the ummah. Looking around, subhanAllah, at everybody, some in sujood, some laughing with their, you know, their friends or their family, some, you know, husband and wife, mother and daughter, father and son, father and daughter, children standing up while everyone is in sujood. I wanted to capture whatever I could, but you can only capture so much, subhanAllah. It was a beautiful night. It was so beautiful, and I was a bit emotional because of how beautiful it was. I wasn't able to pray, which was a bummer, but you know, alhamdulillah, just to be there and experience it, to read the meanings of the Quran, to make dhikr, to make dua, to watch people, to enjoy, to absorb. It's just, I don't know why I'm saying all this like it's the first time I've ever done it, even though it's not. But I don't know, just yesterday was just so special to me. It was just so, the whole program was just so special to me, and I thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I thank him for giving me the opportunity to be there and experience it, because it was just, I know I sound cheesy, but subhanAllah, sisters, it was just the most beautiful night of my life. Most beautiful. So, assalamu alaikum, everybody. Good evening. It's 8:30 p.m. And I still have not been able to sleep, so I've just been reading the Quran, the meaning. I am almost caught up. I think, inshallah, by Saturday I should be completely done reading the whole meaning of the Quran, the whole Quran, inshallah. So I'm quite pleased with myself, alhamdulillah. It seems this year I'm more understanding Allah's words, and some things are hitting me and some things are affecting me, and alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. It's just alhamdulillah. But I told you earlier that I was waiting on one more package, because I wanted to just do, and I'll show you guys what I got all at once instead of breaking it down. So I'm going to start with the smallest thing. But yeah, I got two packages. One from DHL, this one's from Amazon. And in this package, I've got gloves for driving because the son is with the medication and the lupus and everything. I have to, and with it being so hot, oh my gosh, the UV index has been so high. Like today it was 11, subhanAllah. So with all of that being said and having the need to protect my skin, especially while driving, I got myself some gloves to, let me see. Sorry, I keep looking at my phone because I want to let my daughter know when's the best time to, when she should break her fast. So she's heating up her food right now in the kitchen. So I'm just trying to pay attention to let her know she should break her fast. So, but anyways, I got two pairs of gloves. One black, one not black. The other one is white. I'm actually quite excited because these are specifically for driving and they've got, you're able to touch the screen on your phone with these particular gloves, which I thought that would be a huge must, because with my regular lace gloves, I can't really touch the screen unless there's like a hole in the finger or something. And I don't want to mess up gloves like that. But this one, I saw it. It's to protect you from UV rays, from the sun, and also make it easy for you to drive and make it for you to do, you know, touch your phone, like on the touch screen and stuff like that. So I got two pairs of gloves. They're slightly different. One has pretty flower on it. The other one does not. So I'll show you the black one. So this is, I don't even know. Let me see. So here's the black glove. It's lace. It's so pretty, mashallah. It's got a little flower on it. Look at that, guys. It's got a flower on it. It's lace and it's got like a touchpad thingy mabopper right there on the finger and also on the thumb. I'm gonna try it out. Let me see how much time she has left. Break your fast! Yeah. Okay, so that's weird because I didn't get a notification that it was that time yet. But it is now. It is now. So I'm going to try it on. Oh, it's so pretty, mashallah. So let's see. Hopefully it's comfortable. It goes over my sleeve perfectly. Oh my gosh, look at it. It's got dots so it's easy to grip the steering wheel. Oh my gosh, oh my gosh. And then look guys, oh my gosh, look at that. And it's so, my hands are big, so I always fear that gloves will not fit me right. But look at this, it is so cute. Look at that, look at the flower. Oh my gosh, subhanAllah. Time to test them out. Okay, so I'm about to touch my screen. Oh my gosh, subhanAllah, that works. I'm just touching my screen. Oh my gosh, I am in love. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Let's take a look at the white ones. Oh. Oh my gosh, this is the best purchase ever. I don't know. It seems like ever since I learned that about my diagnosis, it's just been easier to just go and just find something to help make it easy on me. So, alhamdulillah, the things you can find on Amazon. All right, so here's the white ones. Oh, this is so cute. Here's the white one. You see this one better than the black one. So again, lace. And it's got, I don't see the touch thingy. It doesn't have the touch like the other one does. I don't know. It's fine, I guess. We'll give it a try, see if it works or not. The other one doesn't have it. But it's got the dots on the hand, so it's easy to grip. Can you guys see? Yeah, there it is. Easy to grip, and it looks like that. It doesn't have a flower, but it has this scrunchy thing right here. So you can see it better right there. Bismillah. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited. Oh, and it fits so comfortably right over the glove. Look. Oh, did my finger just curve? Or no? Looky. All right, so let's see. No touchscreen on this one. So I'll order another pair like the black one later, inshallah, but it doesn't do the touch. See? No touchy. No touchy. But anyways, that's fine because primarily I'll probably be wearing the black ones, but I'm definitely going to get the white ones that looks like this, like the black ones, because I do, if I'm using my navigation, which I do tend to use a lot, especially if I'm going to a new place, or let's say I've got a doctor's office to go to but it's not one that I frequent, I want to make sure that I can touch my navigation system when I need to, if I need to, and having to remove my gloves and whatever, it's just going to be too inconvenient for me. But I love these, but I'm keeping these, and I'm going to use these when I drive for sure. So, I'm excited. All right, lastly, East Essence, my Eid Abaya. Oh, God. I think I only briefly looked at this because when I looked at it again, I was like, maybe I shouldn't have gotten it, but I don't know. We'll see. Inshallah. Let's open it. Is this another Leilani proof bag? I can't even say my name. It's Leilani proof. Either that, or I have no strength in me right now because I'm so tired. Let me see. Oh, here we go. It's working. It's opening. It's done. Sort of. So I got my slip. Oh, it came in a nice package. Yeah. Oh my God. Perfect storage. Which is good because this is not an abaya I would wear to work. So, like, after today, after I eat and having, you know, got it cleaned or cleaned it myself, and I can just put it away in storage into this protective bag. This is good, actually. It even has a zipper. I was about to tell a fib. I was going to say I never ordered an abaya for it. Oh, no. That wasn't a fib. I never did order an abaya from East Essence before. There was an abaya that I did purchase from East Essence before, but it wasn't for the intention of wearing it for Eid. It was like, you know, every going to work abaya. But it was really nice. It was good. I wore it for Eid. It was really good. So, but anyways. Still in a bag. And I keep looking at the viewer, but I like seeing what I'm doing. Okay. I'm so excited. Are you guys ready? I'm not. Ooh, that stinks. I'm gonna have to clean this before I wear it. Ooh. Okay. So. Okay. Here's the top part. It's got this pretty design on there. Sewn on there, it looks like. Yeah, sewn. Look at guys. Can you see that? So pretty. MashaAllah. Okay. I'm just so excited. Gotta eat a baya. Okay, just show it. Okay. So it looks like this. Of course, long sleeves. It's got the bell sleeves. Now, I may have to tuck it into my sleeve here to protect it from dirt until I get inside or until I'm stationary, but it's got the bell sleeves. And I plan on wearing sleeves. I was hoping that I would get my other lace sleeves because I think it would go nicely with this, but I think it's coming from China. I don't know. I might have another. No, I don't. Never mind. Okay, so that. So it looks like this, and it's got this slight opening. Sorry, you guys. Like right here with the trim. I can't see anything, but that's okay. I don't know what I'm touching. Oh, there it is. So it's got this here. You guys are probably laughing at me right about now, but that's okay. I'm laughing with you. As long, oh my God, look at the border. Can you guys, I can't see. No, oh, let me see. Look. Oh, it's so pretty, mashallah. Oh, that's so pretty. Hold on, my arms are starting to show. Lucky. And then, oh gosh, just look at it. It's so pretty. This doesn't go all the way around. This goes just around the front, and it's just bare in the back, which is fine. It is so pretty. Look at the details on that, guys. Look at that. And it opens in the back with the zipper. I don't usually get abayas that open with a zipper, but like that, but this is fine. I mean, I can go to our Eid celebration in my pajamas and just throw this on. Take me 2 seconds to get ready. SubhanAllah. That's the beautiful thing about abayas. You can go anywhere in your pajamas and no one even know except you and Allah. I'm telling you guys, sisters, abayas are a girl's best friend. You say diamonds are a girl's best friend? Oh no, you don't want to mess with you don't want to change out of your pajamas or your shorts or anything of comfort. You just throw on an abaya and go out. No one won't even know. I see so many ladies these days, and I'm not gonna say sisters because I've never ever seen a sister go out looking kind of ratchety, but you go to like store or whatever and you see these ladies are coming out in their literally in their pajamas, like their night shirts, and it's just so much. They're night shirts and they've got this durag on their hair, or their hair is looking a hot mess, and it's like, you know, you can fix that in like 5 seconds flat. Just throw on a net, like a everyday abaya. This is an abaya that you just throw on and head out the house. A hijab, everyday hijab. Just throw it on, go out. You're looking stylish and everything, and modest and respectable. Abayas and hijabs are a girl's best friends. Next to diamonds. Well, for me, mine are pearls, then diamonds. But abayas, oh, I'm so excited to be wearing this. I am so excited to even just be trying to pair it with a hijab. I already have ideas, and I cannot wait to show you guys on Sunday. I cannot wait. Aha! Am I driving gloves? What are you guys wearing for Eid? Let me know in the comments. Let me know what you have worn for Eid if you don't see this by time before Eid goes up or before Eid. Let me know what you wore for Eid al-Fitr. Did you order it? Where did you order it from? What did it look like? Ew, this has definitely got to be a wash before I even put this on. Oh my gosh. Whew. Oh, this is being washed tomorrow night and laid and paired. It's so gorgeous. It just smells. Is there something with this? Sisters, it came with a hijab. Look at that. It came with a hijab. You know what? It would have been nice if they put a trim on it. But it came with a hijab. I didn't know. The instructions didn't say, not instructions, but the description didn't say it came with a hijab. But I got a free hijab. The fabric doesn't go with it, but I got a free hijab. I've never gotten a free hijab before. Oh, this is so awesome. Oh, I am so ready for Eid. Almost. Almost. I just have to pair everything up, wash everything, and set it all aside and ponder and gawk at it and smile. I'm so giddy right now. I'm so excited for Eid. I'm so excited. I don't even know why, but I'm excited. Assalamu alaikum again, everybody. It's 9:30. And I just wanted to give you guys like a quick overview of what I thought about the abaya. Of course, I love the look and still love the look of the abaya. But then I tried it on, guys. I tried the abaya on, and even though it is pretty, I feel like they rushed to get it done because there's a part of the abaya where, you know, almost like a baby doll dress, you have like this, looks like it might be a hem up on the bodice or whatever. Well, it, like a band. For me, it should come up like just below the bosoms. But this one came like at my stomach. Like I'm a short, big person or something. And I'm not, I'm a tall person, 5'7" and some inches. 5'7" 3/4 of an inch. So I'm a tall person. So when I tried the abaya on, the top part seemed to carry a little bit low, and the band like was lower. It was like on my stomach, and so I didn't like that at all. And the other thing is, the bottom of the abaya where it has the beautiful gold trim didn't come down long enough. When I looked at it, I lay down and I kind of stretched myself out. I wanted to see how it looked and, you know, does it come down to my toes? Because I like my abayas to come to the floor. It has to touch the floor. It didn't touch the floor. The back, you know, like the fabric around it did. Of course, it kind of dragged on the floor, just maybe like a couple of inches. But the trim on the main part of the abaya that has the beautiful gold trim, the embroidered trim, it did not come down to the floor, and I don't like that. So it makes me worry that, because when I sit down, I like my feet to be covered. If the abaya is short, you have to adjust yourself a certain way, or rather, I have to adjust myself a certain way to make sure that my feet are covered when I'm out and about. So I'm covered from head to toe. I really don't like my feet to show, especially if I plan on wearing sandals. I really don't want my feet to show. And I do plan on wearing sandals because I have lesions on my bottoms of my feet and on one of my toes, and the wearing flats would constrict my feet and not allow my feet to just be comfortable. So I plan on wearing sandals. If I'm wearing sandals, I want to make sure that the abaya goes over my feet, not only to protect it from the sun, but also just for my own privacy's sake. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. After trying it on, I was like, okay, let me just pair it with other things that I have an idea for. So I put on a hijab, and like an Amira hijab, because if it's going to be warm, I put a lightweight Amira hijab first, so that whatever perspiration or sweat, whatever, it will soak into that and not the nice hijab. So I did that, and then I took out my hijab that has a gold trim, but the gold is brighter than the gold on the abaya. And so I was thinking, well, maybe not. Then I took out a niqab. I have an idea of which niqab I plan on wearing, depending on how I'm going to style it. And then I took out jewelry pieces and how I'm going to style it into the niqab and onto the abaya, or with the abaya and on my fingers. And so I did that, and alhamdulillah, I've got the vision that I want. But the problem is, I don't like how the abaya fits. I mean, it's beautiful and everything, but it seems like it's for someone who may be a little bit bigger, a little bit larger, maybe not a little bit like larger than me, maybe more bosoms than me, and shorter than me. And that's how it looked to me. Maybe not too much shorter, but shorter than me. The way it would fill out a person who's larger. So I'm not quite pleased with it. I still put everything aside that I intend to wear with it if I decide to wear it. I'm right now 50-50 on that. But if I decide not to, then I do have an abaya in the closet that I can wear. The only thing is that it's bright, and I don't know. I mean, I can kind of tone it down by wearing a really large black hijab, like that I bought from Al Mujalbaba, and you know, fashion it a certain way so that it covers up the majority of it, so to take away the brightness, the huge brightness of it, and wear the butterfly niqab with the red trim because it would match it. That's pretty much it. So I have that as a backup just in case. And I do have a jewelry piece or two that can go with it as well. So that's going to be my backup in case I change my mind. I'm not confident that I'm going to wear this new abaya from East Essence. This is the first time I've been disappointed. And probably the first time I'm going to be returning something to them. So, yeah. And with that being said, with the thought of me returning it, washing it is out of the question. So, subhanallah, rabbil alameen. We'll see. But anyways, I am really tired. I have to drink some more water, take my medicine, maybe eat a little bit of something, and then go to bed early because I am still very much tired. My eyes have been heavy all day just heavy, and I haven't been able to just lie down and go to sleep. So since I'm on my menses, this is like the best time to just go ahead and go to sleep. So I hope you all enjoyed the vlog. Maybe it's not as short as I thought it was going to be, but inshallah you've enjoyed the vlog. Definitely give it a thumbs up. I cannot wait for Eid again, but now I've got a dilemma what to wear. Anyways, I love you all for the sake of Allah. Subscribe if you haven't subscribed. Leave a comment. leave a comment if you ever got an abaya that you were disappointed, about for a special occasion. Let me know in the comments below what was your reaction and what did you do in the end. So, alright, I'll see you in the next vlog, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bye.